from Center City, this is Good Day Philadelphia.
112 patients who received treatment for prostate cancer at the Philadelphia VA Medical Center within the last 6 years are being asked to return. Medical Center is concerned these patients received lower radiation doses than prescribed. Well, for more on this story, local attorney Tom Kline joins us from New York this morning. Good morning, Tom. How are you?
Good morning, John. How are you?
Tom, when you hear about this story, what do you make of the report when you first hear it?
Well, I make of it that many patients were undertreated. They had a cancer treatment, a protocol that was called out. It's a national protocol. It's something which prescribes exactly the dosage. And here, 114 patients who we know about did not get the amount of treatment. No one who has cancer, no one who has any kind of disease or problem wants to be undertreated. And that's the problem here. The question is, what are the consequences?
Yeah, well, 112 they want back. Two of them have died, making the 114 patients total. What recourse would these patients have and their families have against the hospital?
Well, John, under Pennsylvania law, a patient can bring a lawsuit if there was an increased risk of harm to them as a result of someone's misconduct or someone's, in this case, professional negligence. The question in this case isn't whether the treatment was improper. I think the VA admits that the treatment was improper. The real question here is whether the treatment caused any harm. That may be difficult to prove, but the standard in Pennsylvania for the families of anyone who died or whose cancer spread, and that's really the key point, did their cancer spread, or did they eventually die from the lack of treatment or the under-treatment here? Here's a cancer treatment. It's seeding. There are seeds that are put in, radioactive seeds. The seeds are there to eradicate the cancer in patients who have a early cancer. So the real problem here is, did the cancer spread as a result of the failure to treat, a recognition of the cancer, then a treatment that was really inadequate? That's the issue that any family would face if they were going to bring a lawsuit against the VA.
And now another case that the VA is also looking into has to do with an Air Force veteran on blood thinner, had his blood drawn on July 30th, and then was put into a research study without his or his family's consent. I mean, you go into a hospital and you do trust these professionals that they're going to do everything in line. What about this case? Where do you see this one going?
Well, the VA says that these two incidents are coincidental, and they don't seem to be related, at least as a problem. But it shows you that there's some systemic problems that exist at the VA. Here, it boils down to a simple proposition. No one in a hospital is allowed to do a procedure without, and that includes taking blood, without a patient's consent. Mm-hmm. And there's an admission. They were doing a study. The study apparently is a worthwhile and a good study and an approved study, but then they didn't tell the patient. In this case, appears that there's more than one patient. One patient happened to, as the public report indicates, when he complained, he was given a vial of blood back. He said, well, gee, what am I supposed to do with it? Am I supposed to now put it in my refrigerator? That's because he complained. But the issue is really a broader one, John. The issue is, when you're in a hospital, are you entitled to give consent to any procedure that's done? And the answer is yes, and the VA was wrong in this situation. The damages, the consequences, well, they probably are insignificant, but I think you and anyone out there could appreciate that consent is an important issue, and that's why it's an important public issue.
Obviously, a couple of cases we'll keep following. Tom Kline from New York, we appreciate you joining us this morning. The Medical Center now has set up a toll-free number to answer any questions veterans or their families may have. The number is 1-866-709-4589.